Hi, this is Scott Hanselman. Let's take a look at some of the HTML editing features of Visual Studio 2013. It's got HTML5 support, full HTML5 support. If I just come into an HTML page here and just hit HTML5 and then hit Tab, it fills out. I've got IntelliSense for everything. There's the new main, brand new main element. If I start typing something else, like something else, you notice that the end tag matches as well. I could go and do things like audio, hit Tab, and then some kind of a file name and hit Enter. We've got all of the kinds of things that you would expect aside like that. We've also got IntelliSense for Angular. So Angular applications use the Angular JavaScript library, and then we've got some handlebar templates here. You see this here, we've got syntax highlighting in the handlebar. So here we're saying the service name and then the price in currency. And we're pulling this out of this ng app and ng controller. There's the controller that's in another JavaScript here. You'll notice that if I start typing ng, we get a dot, dot, dot IntelliSense. And then if I hit hyphen, that actually opens up. So we've got all the different things that someone who's doing Angular work could potentially want to do. So if I go ahead and just run this app, this is all running on the client side using HTML5 and Angular. We've also got support for style sheets within HTML, of course, as well we should. But what this means is that you get the full power of the CSS style sheet editor, including the color picker and fonts and all the kinds of things that you would want inside of the HTML editor. So that's inline CSS3 style editing in the HTML editor itself. We've also got Knockout. So if I open up Knockout, this is another way to do client-side development. This is more model view view model rather than model view controller. We have IntelliSense inside of data binding. So here if I say something like value and then start typing, I've got IntelliSense inside of the attribute of this element. This is actually coming out of JavaScript, this first name right here. We can go down here to the view model. We can go down here to the view model and see the view model's first name and last name. Those are actually getting pulled out, and we've got IntelliSense within the editor here as well. So that's pretty cool. There's lots of really good IntelliSense stuff going on in 2013, including things like classes. So if I type class, these are two active CSS classes. I've got IntelliSense for that. Also IDs. Here's an ID of pants. That ID is actually coming out of here. If I go and put in something else and then go back, we've got IntelliSense for that as well. We've got IntelliSense for entities, which is really convenient. So you actually hit the ampersand and you notice all the different HTML entities that you might want to get, like copyright, tab. There's also some other conveniences like bringing in media files. Here, if I go and drag in a MP4 and drop it, I can get video and source automatically. And the same thing applies with images. And of course, if I hover over the image, I can see a thumbnail of what that image is going to look like. There's lots of really nice HTML editing features in 2013. If you're a front-end developer doing HTML5, doing handlebars, Knockout, Angular, any kind of JavaScript or front-end development, you're going to feel comfortable right away. We try to have IntelliSense for anything that's that makes sense, anything that's going to make you a smarter and more powerful front-end developer. I hope you enjoy it.